Hello and welcome to Istanbul, Turkey. We all know that Western Europe and East Asia are home to some of the fastest trains in the world. But did you know that Turkey is also building a high-speed rail network that will link up all its major cities? For my first train video filmed outside Australia, I decided to go somewhere that is less well-known. So today I'm going to travel on Turkey's first high-speed train line from Istanbul to Ankara. Let's go!
Istanbul is Turkey's financial center. It has a population of over 15 million people, making it the most populous city in Europe. It's also the world's largest transcontinental city. The Bosphorus Strait is considered the boundary between Europe and Asia, and Istanbul straddles both sides of it. Personally, what I love about this city are its history, the food, and the friendly people. Being a city that connects Europe and Asia, Istanbul has been an important rail hub since the late 19th century. There were two major railway termini in the city. The one on the European side is Söğütlüçeşme railway station. You may not be familiar with its name, but I'm sure you've heard of a train called the Orient Express. The current terminal building was built in 1890 by the Oriental Railway, and Söğütlüçeşme was the train's eastern terminus until 2009. Söğütlüçeşme terminal had 4 platforms and 7 tracks, serving Istanbul commuter, Turkey regional and international trains to nearby European nations. Unfortunately, this famous station was closed to long-distance trains in 2013, and today it is only used by Istanbul's Marmaray commuter trains. The Turkish State Railways TCDD still has a ticket office at Söğütlüçeşme terminal. But if you like to catch the train from Istanbul to Western Turkey and the rest of Europe, you now have to take the Marmaray to Halkalı station, which is over 27 kilometers away. The rail terminus on the Asian side of Istanbul is Haydarpaşa station. It used to be the primary terminal for trains traveling to and from Eastern Turkey, and it was the country's busiest railway station. However, this historical station was closed in 2012 and its future remained unclear. Hopefully, it will be redeveloped at the terminus of the high-speed trains. At the moment, trains between Istanbul and the Anatolian region of Turkey, including my train to Ankara, depart from the nearby Söğütlüçeşme station. Söğütlüçeşme is located 1.4 kilometers east of Haydarpaşa. It has 4 platforms. Platforms 1 and 2 are used by the Marmaray, and platforms 3 to 4 are used as a temporary terminus of the long distance trains. Purchasing a train ticket in Turkey is fairly straightforward. There are ticket counters at most major stations, or you can book online through the official Turkish State Railways website. Booking for most domestic trains opens 30 days before departure, and you can even select your seats. To catch the long-distance train at Söğütlüçeşme, you have to put your luggage through an X-ray machine. After that, the staff will check your ticket and your photo ID before you can take the escalators up to the platforms. My train is scheduled to depart at 9:15, and boarding commenced only 25 minutes before departure. If you arrive early, there's a small waiting area with luggage lockers. The high-speed train in Turkey is called Yüksek Hızlı Tren, short for YHT. The trains currently come in two varieties. The first generation is TCDD HT80000. They were designed by CAF in Spain, based on the Renfe Class 120 trains. They have a top operating speed of 250 km per hour and typically run in a 6-car formation. The newer type of the YHT is TCDD HT80000, also known as Velaro TR. They were built by Siemens in Germany. Each set comes in an 8-car formation with a top speed of 300 km per hour. Other than Turkey and Germany, the Velaro class can also be seen in Belgium, France, the United Kingdom, the Netherlands, Spain, China, and Russia. My ride this morning is operated by an 8-car Velaro. Let's hop on board! Car 1 is a business class carriage. The seats are in a 1-2 configuration with a total of 15 rows. None of the seats is rotatable, therefore only half of them face the direction of travel. At the rear of each carriage, there is dedicated luggage space for large suitcases. The first half of car 2 has 3 business class compartments. Each has privacy screen doors and each seat can rotate for around 45 degrees. These compartments are perfect for business travelers wishing to make phone calls and conduct a meeting, or those traveling in a group of 4. The second half of car 2 is fitted with standard economy class seats in a 2-2 configuration. Compared to only having 15 rows in business, a standard economy class carriage has 21 rows of economy seats. But the legroom still looks decent. Each seat is equipped with a large tray table, footrest, USB port, and there's a power plug shared between 2 seats. Car 3 is a restaurant carriage. I must say, this whole train looks modern and incredibly clean. I think I'm going to have a great time on this 4.5-hour journey to Ankara. And I'm looking forward to enjoying a hot meal in this restaurant car later. The rest of the train, from car 4 to car 8, are all fitted with economy class seats. Car 4 has an office for the train guard and 2 accessible spaces. As most passengers were already on board, I did not continue my filming in cars 5 to 8, but like I said, they all are just economy class seats. The first railway line from Istanbul to Ankara was opened in 1892. Trains can run on the existing tracks at a maximum speed of 160 km per hour. In order to allow the YHT to travel faster, the construction of a high-speed railway commenced in 2003. The line was opened in stages between 2009 and 2019. The tracks of the new line are primarily laid parallel to the existing railway, and they enabled the YHT to travel at 250 km per hour after passing Izmit. Let's have a more detailed look at the business class seat. The 1-2 configuration made the carriage feel less crowded, and the train is quiet and smooth when in motion. The overhead TVs show the train's speed and upcoming stations. The seat had a large foldable tray table, a seat pocket, a footrest, a power plug under the seat in front, and 2 USB ports under your seat. In addition, the ergonomic cushion and the headrest have made the seat quite comfortable to sit in. There's a personal entertainment screen hidden inside the armrest. Earphones are not provided, so if you wish to watch a movie, you'll have to bring your own. The system is not the latest on the market, but it is a touchscreen with a lot to offer. There's internet on board, and I'll get back to that later. If you tap the information section, you can find the train's timetable, moving map and the live onboard camera. This is very cool. The news tab provides information on the weather forecast and headlines of the latest breaking news. In terms of the entertainment, there are TV shows, music, e-books, and as you can see, there's a great selection of movies to choose from. To access the internet, you have to put in the booking reference number on your train ticket and seat number. The internet is complimentary for business class passengers. I was expecting the screen to generate a password for me to connect my phone to the onboard Wi-Fi. Turned out that the screen itself can become a web browser. The internet is fast enough for me to search things on Google, check out my Instagram feed, and even watch a YouTube video. However, this also means that there's no Wi-Fi on this train. The distance between Söğütlüçeşme and Ankara is 560 km. If traveling at a speed of 250 km per hour, it shouldn't have to take the YHT 4.5 hours to complete this journey, right? The longer than expected journey time is because the 43-kilometer line between Söğütlüçeşme and Gebze only has three tracks. Two of them are used by the Marmaray, and the YHT from both directions can only use a single track. And the reason for only having three tracks instead of four is that the areas around the line are heavily urbanized. Building another track would require demolishing hundreds of properties. Furthermore, the speed limit is restricted to 120 km per hour.
Dear ladies, gentlemen and children, high-speed train which goes to Ankara. Thank you for choosing Turkey Republic State Railways Transport Corporation.
Approximately 40 minutes after our departure, the staff came over to offer business class passengers a complimentary snack box. There's bread, a marble cake, a juice box and a small bottle of water. The portion is big enough for a morning snack, but in my opinion, not enough for lunch. Well, again, I'm looking forward to checking out what food the restaurant car has to offer later. After passing İzmit, there are finally four tracks on the railway line, with the two northern tracks being mostly used by the YHT. After Kuşadağı, approximately 100 km from Istanbul, the remainder of the line to Ankara was newly built, and the train can finally run at 250 km per hour. The Turkish State Railways started modernizing its entire fleet in the 1990s to stop losing market share to roads. Between 1993 and 2005, TCDD introduced over 300 brand new TVS 2000 railcars for its regional trains. Depending on the service you travel on, there are coach cars, dining cars, cushioned cars, sleeping cars, and generator cars. Although not as fast as the YHT, the TVS 2000 are also very clean and comfortable to travel on. I'll show you more about them in my next video. Here's a quick tour of the toilet. There's one at the end of each carriage. It is clean and has plenty of space. Car 4 is equipped with an even bigger accessible toilet to accommodate passengers traveling in wheelchair. It's almost lunchtime, therefore I headed to the restaurant car looking for a hot meal. Unfortunately, TCDD did not make good use of the kitchen. All they had were some cold snacks and drinks. The price seems reasonable, but I think this is quite disappointing. I always love having a meal on the train while enjoying the ever-changing scenery outside. In the end, I only purchased a can of Coke. We are now in Eskişehir. This junction station is one of the largest and busiest stations in Turkey. It is served by many intercity and regional trains, as well as the YHT to Istanbul, Ankara and Karaman. Inaugurated in 2009, the 246-kilometer line from here to Ankara was the first section of the Ankara-Istanbul high-speed railway to be constructed, and it's the first high-speed rail line in the Middle East. Travelling at 250 km per hour, Ankara is not too far away. Overall, I enjoyed this trip. The YHT have reduced travel time between Istanbul and Ankara from 7.5 to 11 hours to 4.5 hours. The tickets are affordable and the service is popular among locals. I love how comfortable and smooth the Velaro train is. And the scenery outside is beautiful. My only disappointment is being unable to enjoy a hot meal in the dining car. In addition, the train staff don't speak much English, but they are friendly. I find it helpful to have Google Translate open on my phone when communicating with them. Welcome to Ankara, the capital and the second largest city in Turkey. Since opening the first high-speed railway in 2009, Ankara has become the main hub for the YHT. This building, built above the YHT platforms, was opened in 2016, containing an information desk, ticket offices, waiting rooms and a VIP lounge. We will learn more about the station in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. If you find this video interesting or helpful, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more train and flight reviews. See you all in my next video.